All right, Kevin Jordan here, back in the garden here at Capital Public Radio, here at Sacramento State University. I'm here meeting my really good friend, Patio Pat, and he's gonna school me up on how to get my garden started by, hey, how's it going, Patty?
Hey, Kevin, man, good to see you. A dirty handshake,
oh,
I love it.
Both dirty.
So what do we got here? Beefmaster tomato. Do you like this tomato?
I love it. Love tomatoes.
Did you ever transplant one of these tomatoes in the garden? You get a start from the nursery, maybe Green Acres Nursery and
Teach
Supply.
Me the best way.
So what I like to do is I like to start with this product. It's like a starter fertilizer. It helps reduce that transplant shock.
Will it burn the plant if I use a little too much?
This stuff is such an organic friendly product. It's really hard to burn plants with it. It's a slower acting fertilizer. So what I want you to do is I want you to dig a little hole where we're gonna put this tomato, and let's put a little bit of this Sure Start in there.
Oh, I love it. Love to feel that dirt.
So you could just take a handful, or you can look in the directions if you want to be conservative.
Now, should I plant it too high, or should I put it deeper in the hole with the tomato?
Put it in the hole a little bit.
All right, great.
Down there next to that Sure Start fertilizer.
Can I bury up the stem a little bit?
Bury up the stem. You can even knock a couple branches down if they're in the way, but this looks like we're going to leave them. It looks pretty good there. That's how I do it in my garden, and I seem to have some success. That looks great there. Yeah, let's do one more tomato.
All right.
This is a celebrity variety. It is very disease resistant. So sometimes if you're unsure, the tag will tell you how far to space your plants apart.
All right, so I'm gonna grab some of that starter fertilizer.
Excellent, yep. Throw it in here, we'll mix it in.
It looks colorful, there's so many things in it. Oh yeah. A lot of compost in the soil.
This soil looks really good. Where'd you get? Next thing, I want you to help me transplant some of these flowers. I like to do flowers in between my vegetable garden. I think it helps bring the pollinators.
You know it.
So I think we're going to get more tomatoes if we plant some of these flowers out here. Where do you think we should plant these flowers, Kevin?
I think right here along this border, in between some of these bigger plants, would be fantastic. God, I love begonias too. They're so beautiful. And what's nice, I noticed that some of them get a little burnt up in our hot summer. What's nice is by the time these tomatoes get big, that's when the hot summer's gonna come, and these will be underneath their shade, just getting enough sunshine to really be happy.
Yeah. Start fertilizer, anytime you transplant, whether it's an ornamental or an edible, this is a really friendly product to your seedlings or your transplant starts if you get your stuff at the nursery.
And it's not toxic to me to touch, right?
This is totally organic.
Yeah, you know, I've heard of people putting also like herbs in between some of their tomatoes, things like basil, cilantro, and that can also help as a companion planting.
You know, that's great that you mentioned that. Companion planting is really taking off right now. There's the real popular one called the Three Sisters, where they grow the corn, squash, and beans. Squash and beans.
Oh yeah, I've always wanted to do that.
Yeah, and I've always heard that basil and onions go well with tomatoes as well. Yeah, if you come into to Green Acres Nursery and Supply, or you come out here to the garden, you can see some of the companion plantings that we have going on, where we have the herbs mixed in next to the strawberries. So we're showing you right here how to plant these begonias, but you could plant your herbs like your oregano, or maybe your basil, or your catnip, or your thyme.
That sounds like a caprese salad ready to go right there, you know?
You'd be surprised how many of these herbs are delicious in your salads or in your smoothies, and how many vitamins and minerals you can get from them.
And that's actually an important point, is that if you don't have a big garden at your home, don't worry about it. Don't let that stop you from having a delicious garden. You can start with just having herbs in pots. Having fresh basil on your patio is one of the best things that you can have to spice up your food and make it just taste super fresh and zesty, and then and also get your fingers dirty in the process and have fun growing. So don't be limited by the size of your garden.
Thanks for coming out. Remember, everybody, grow healthy, grow happy.